My name is Heather Slusser with the University of Wisconsin Extension in Marathon County. Today I'm going to talk to you about the breeding soundness examination and what it does and does not evaluate. The breeding soundness exam is a quick, down and dirty way of assessing whether or not your bull is potentially fertile or not. During the exam, the technician will assess physical defects of the bull, the overall body condition score of the bull, and the reproductive tract of the bull. During the physical examination, the technician will look to see if there are any warts, physical defects, leg abnormalities of the bull that will prevent him from walking the pasture. He will also assess the overall condition of the bull to see if he has enough body condition score to make it through the breeding season. The technician will assess the various reproductive tract components. He will observe the scrotum and look for any signs of damage or injury to the scrotum. He will palpate the testicles, feeling for any abnormalities or softness in the tissue indicating degeneration. He will also palpate the epididymis, again, feeling for softness or degeneration of the epididymis. The technician should also evaluate the penis, looking for any hair rings or frenulums that might be present. If hair rings or frenulums are present at the time of the bull breeding soundness exam, they may be able to be corrected at this time. The penis is also evaluated for warts, which, if small enough, may be removed at the time of the breeding soundness exam as well. Once the physical examination or the external examination of the bull is completed, the technician should also assess the semen quality. The technician should collect ejaculations in a humane manner, working with the bull to collect a sample and then promptly examining it underneath a microscope. The technician should also assess the color of the semen, which should be opaque and milky white. He should assess the concentration of the semen, should also assess the sperm motility and morphology. You want progressive motility greater than 40%, and no more than 25% of the sperm should have morphological defects. Sperm morphology is best measured after staining the sample and then observing at 400x magnification with oil immersion. So you should make sure the technician is not just looking at the semen under a glass slide. The results of the evaluation will tell you if the breeder is a satisfactory potential breeder, whether or not the bull needs to be looked at a different time. Maybe it's a young bull that doesn't have quality semen right now, but there is the potential for that semen quality to increase. Bulls coming off of winter time will sometimes have lower than average semen quality and will need to be reassessed at a later period of time. The breeding soundness exam can also tell you if the bulls are unsatisfactory potential breeders, meaning they probably will not breed even after a reassessment. We classify the bulls as potential breeders because the breeding soundness exam does not take into account several factors. The first of these factors is being the bull's libido, or the bull's sex drive. You need to measure on your own the serving capacity of the bulls. How many females does he try to breed within a given period of time? Besides doing a quick and dirty body condition scoring, which is not always included in every breeding soundness exam, the test does not look at the nutrition of the bull. During the breeding season, bulls tend to eat less. They use up body fat. They use up about 150 pounds during the breeding season. The test also does not take into account the feed stuff that you are feeding the bull. So you need to examine your nutrition and your ration and make sure it's formulated the energy needs of your bull. The breeding soundness exam also does not take into account social interactions of the bull and other bulls in the pasture or of the bull and females within the pasture. The breeding soundness exam does not look at the bull to female ratio. Keep in mind that if you have a yearling or a two-year-old bull, you're going to be able to house fewer females with those bulls than if you had a three-year-old or older bull. Also, if there are multiple sires within the herd, you will notice a pecking order that is established. This pecking order will determine the dominant bull versus the submissive bull or the less dominant bulls. The dominant bulls will get his pick of the females in the herd, leaving the remainder for those submissive bulls or the less dominant bulls. The breeding soundness exam also does not assess the environmental conditions that the bull is exposed to. Environmental conditions such as heat stress or cold stress can affect the semen quality of the bull, and particularly heat stress can affect that bull's want to breed On overly hot days, the bull's not going to want to move and walk the pasture, therefore decreasing his opportunities to breed. The breeding soundness exam also does not assess the female of the herd, and so even if the bull is fertile, we still have half the equation that we have not looked at. Thank you for listening to this video on breeding soundness exams. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. Thank you.